Koestler Trust has got in touch to see if I'm interested in working with them for the next exhibition. I just said yes straight away, to be honest. I definitely want to be a part of that. Strength and vulnerability are like the two sort of subject matters that I speak about the most within music, and that they feel very sort of connected. There's a real duality between the two of those things, and to make the exhibition personal to me just made sense to focus on those. The good thing is I've kind of got it compartmentalized in my mind. I want to show movement within those things, like not be rigid in strength and rigid in vulnerability, movement between those things. My idea for the exhibition was to split the exhibition into sort of three sections. The first section being strength, and then moving into the second area, if you kind of get to the sort of core of things, which is the vulnerability and that kind of reveal. And I want that second room to be that kind of reveal. And then the third space, I want to be, you know, once you've gone through that reveal, then it's about building back up in a safe way, a place that's safe and comfortable. I like this because it gives me room free vibes. It's tea, and my mum always drinks tea. And for me, mum and just her drinking tea is a safe place, do you know what I mean? I don't actually know what this is, but I really like it though. The hands of time. Oh, there are hands in here. Oh, and there is, it looks like there were clocks here as well. This might work either for the first one or even for the second one. It's giving me one vibes. This is giving me the first one vibes. It's very loud and quite troubling a little bit as well. This is gonna be room one. It's a mix between the idea of having a bunker that was storing pieces of art that represented strength and vulnerability, and also a mix between the fact that, you know, these pieces of art come from places that are very similar to a bunker. It's walls, it's closed in. What is inside of it doesn't get an opportunity to come out unless taken out. But yet still within that, there's all of this beautiful art. I picked out some cool pieces today though. Especially this, you never, what is it? You never really grow up, especially that piece. It's this real statement piece. The thing that made me want to be a part of it was the fact that it was art by offenders. It's about the things that I'm about as an artist, you know what I mean? It's about the social issues, it's about speaking for people that don't necessarily have a loud voice in society. The room's been cleared out and it's just kind of just left in here things I've picked out so far, which is good. It's good to get a have a clear space and be able to see it. Also, I'm thinking I can just easily split things into sections. Got 1, 2, 3 walls, so may as well use that to put stuff together in the three different sections. I can see strength and vulnerability there. Strong little puppy, but the puppy's strong enough to pee on Superman's leg. Maybe the lightheartedness of it is three. I don't want one to be angry. Strength isn't equal to anger. I think this is in there. I also picked out this. Her stance looks like she's paying attention and she's willing to take on board what somebody's about to say, which is kind of gives me two vibes. I'm, you know, stripped below the first surface. I'm open. I feel like this person has said the same thing a few times. I think that's her one, trying to get attention. It's the view. It's the penthouse view. The bone man, he or she is in such a sort of vulnerable stance. What we can see is bone. What we can physically see is something strong and something vulnerable at the same time, which I think is really nice. I think when people come in to see it, I'm hoping that they'll be able to get the idea of strength and vulnerability, because in my mind, I like the idea of these works of art showing me something about myself. You know, I think that's what art should do. I've seen a head. I really like it. It's a self-portrait. Tough, strong. That's kind of the vibe I'm getting from this.
Oh, yes. One.
These sort of in prayer sculptures, they're all quite really vulnerable and exposed, which works really well for two. Crying, praying, holding a belly, praying again. I feel like I just got some goodies or something. He's physically strong. It takes a lot of strength to be able to do that. And you've got to be able to just give in. It's kind of what two's about, so I think I'm gonna pop him a two. I love how naturally shaped she is, you know, a very poor woman. And also, the nakedness is what works for me in two, stripped down. So, that's good, we've got her. You know, the material that people are using to do the artwork on, it's just amazing. It's bringing it to life for me. It's not just a picture on a piece of paper. It's just art and everything. That's life. It can't be restricted to one platform. I've seen pieces of art that I think is just mind blown. Do you know what I mean? It's just mind equals blown. Why is this coming from here? You know what I'm saying? What happened along this journey? What kind of curveball was this, man? Because there's things here that are just meant to be seen. They're too beautiful not to be seen. This second time going through the exhibition, there's absolutely stuff that I missed. I mean, it's a good idea to go back through things. You just can't take it all in at one time, do you know what I mean? There's so much. She looks pretty strong to me. She's giving me single mum vibes. She looks like a tough cookie, man. This is giving me strength and vulnerability. A strong boat. It's got to be a big, strong boat, well built. But it's also so vulnerable to the sea, which is also so strong. I think the most difficult part of curating would be the actual space itself. I'm a rapper. I'm not an exhibition curator. I want it to feel different to other exhibitions because I'm bringing something different to the project. I want it to be powerful when it's in there, and I want it to feel powerful because it is. There's something about putting on a mask that gives me one feelings. Sometimes you've got to pretend that you're strong. This is matchstick works. So I'm just having a look. Seeing what's here. It's a grand piano. It really appeals to me. The musician likes the matchstick grand piano. Yes, that's in there. A lot of art here is about escapism. It's about remembering a warmer place, a nicer place, and things like this, the waves in the sea and the ocean and stuff. And possibly the person that drew the ship in the middle of the storm has never seen a ship in the middle of a storm. Do you know what I'm saying? That's the emotion that was inside and that's what came out. Certainly something that I've struggled with during curating the project is leaving work out. There's things that felt so powerful, I felt like they didn't work for this. And it made me kind of wish there was another one happening, do you know what I mean, as well, that we could get it all in there. Well, today's the last day, so it's my last opportunity to pick out. Over the weekend, I was listening to the audio and reading the written works. When I came back in today, it felt right, which was a good sign. When I looked at each section, they felt that there was a strong sense of what I'm trying to do. Ooh, the canteen. It's pretty dark. Basically, the written works, I think I want them to be what joins the sections, whereas these are more that section one, that section two, this section three. The written work can be a written explanation of how one gets to two, how two gets to three. That would be amazing if that was to happen. I like this right here. I think this is safe. Yeah. I feel good now that it's all picked. Definitely. I feel really good about it. Yeah. So the next stage is meeting up with the designer at the South Bank, looking at the space and working out how we're gonna make this feel right and feel like some sort of a bunker. And I'm still absolutely chuffed and honored that I'm even being able to curate it. I can't wait to see it actually, you know, come to life on a day.
Growing up young, young, my conscience was high, yeah, chilling in the park, in two states of mind. One side's telling me to give it some time. All I knew was struggle and survive, it was part of my life.